So now, so far we were talking about the hazards due to sleeplessness and second obesity, and what is the importance of our regular exercise means to keep our body fit, how it is important. It is very important. We have to have our control on diet, control on our flabbing up. Flabbing up means what I want to say is getting a round shape, or to increase our weight, putting on our weight. There we should be very much in control. We have to control it, because we have already seen a person there at a very young age of 46 years. He died because of the heart attack, because the, what we can say, the blood vessels, they do not have place enough to carry the blood to all the parts. They could not scatter, they failed. And if the blood vessels are failing, heart also fails. So that we have seen. And next comes how to keep your body fit and how you can maintain your health. You have to control your diet. What you are eating, how much you are eating, that is a very, what we can say, is a very important thing. I mean, what you are eating, I don't know, sir. It is an edible thing, no, I am eating. No, it should not be like that. You should have a check what you are eating. And how many hours you are sleeping. What exercise you are doing. No, sir, if I go, no, sir, for bed, no, sir, I am not getting sleep, sir. Many, sir, sir, but you are not doing exercise, sir. Means whatever your body needs, they are to be given for the longevity of your life. Right? So now, here the writer recommends, the unit one recommends, what is it called? Sports. Games, those are, what we can say, they improve the mental agility. Chess is there, it is a game. Carrom board, game. These all, they improve your mental agility. How speed your mind is working. How fast it is thinking, in the capacity of thinking. And how much it is storing the information. This depends on how you are playing the games. For the example, chess. Example, your carroms. These are indoor games, sit and play. Even cards, people play solitaire, people play rummy. Don't think that it is out of skills. No, they need skills. Unless you have skills, you cannot play them. Even if it is a card, people may say it is a bad habit. But how much brain you are using, let us not think how much energy I am wasting over there. I should not be on that only. Again, games means you are not your computer games. You are using your brain, no doubt, but you should not lock your mind with that. We have already seen in our literature about one lesson over there. So you should not lock your mind. It should be open, it should be refreshed, and you should think, it should store games. Sports at the same time. Sports, they build your body. They check your body. They keep the body in fit condition. Sports, they are very essential. There are n number of games, there are n number of sports. Certain sports, they help you to build your body, and certain are there, they help you to have teamwork, and there are certain things whereupon a man can get a very good position in the society. Means, through the sports, you are gaining treble, three times you are gaining. So you have to have some sport within you. If you don't play anything but have sportive spirit, means you can keep your body always strong and agile and fit for anything, anytime. So there is a paragraph here. Let us read the paragraph, and thereafter we have how socially you get acclaim. There are many personalities. I need not tell you. Here one personality is there, and very unknown game, there it has been taken to you. You are well versed with cricket. And Sachin Tendulkar, I need not tell you the name. And even your MS Dhoni, I need not tell you his name. Right? Kapil Dev, I need not tell your name. You know many names in that one. And in what match, where he got the man of the match, and how many matches he played, how many runs he has done, how many wickets he has taken, right? So that all, what we can say, statistics, you are well versed with. But when it comes to golf, we are undone. We don't know any personality there. Here the writer introduces you with a golf personality, right? And moreover, the writer gives you n number of names of the sports. Some are water sports, some are air, some are ice, some are on the earth. You will be contesting in that sports, right? What are those names and where they are played? We should have that knowledge if at all we are writing an essay on, especially on sports, games and sports. Blindly we should not write anything. We should know some details. Those details have been given here. And about Ashok Kumar, I have written over here. India's Indian golfer he is. And let us see how he had come to rags to riches, we say. Rags to riches means what? He was not having money to meet both the ends. Right? Many people come from Bihar, UP and many other places, they come here. From here also many people go to other states. Maharashtra, if you see Mumbai, Mumbai is a place where you can see a person of many tongues, you can see there. Means Malayalis are there, Tamils are there, Odias are there, Bengalis are there. You name the state, that personality over there, that persons are there. Why? Because we can earn over there. Whatever is there, whether I have the qualification or not, I can earn. So that takes you there. Likewise, many people come to Hyderabad. Why? Here also there are many scopes for earning. So they come over here. Madras, the same thing. The cosmopolitan cities, metro cities are like that. You can earn, you can live, you can survive over there. Right? So likewise, certain people from Bihar and Bengal and all these places, they go to Delhi. They stay there. What works they do? Very small errands they do, very small. Right? And from there too, he has reached to a very world fame. He has seen world fame because of a sport, because of a game. Right? So after reading this, we will be having an understanding what sports play in our life. So let us see paragraph D here under the name The World of Sports. What does it say here? Here, play is an integral part of human nature. By turning a usual activity into a sport or a play, man has shown himself the way to indulge in it and concentrate on it over a period of time and get daily doses of benefits out of it. Over a period of time, if you are a sportsman, if you are playing football, continuously for certain years, you will have to play, you will be playing. If you don't play, you cannot take rest. That way you will be mad after that sport. You have done that. Say, considerably for 10 years you have played. Thereafter, whatever you have recovered in that period, it will last for your life. You will be benefited installments, as if you are paying EMIs. Likewise, you will be benefited in installments during your life period. So that is the importance of your sports. You have to play at a time. So next one again, if you see, this is the reason why sports and games from time immemorial. Immemorial means we don't remember even What was the time when the games and sports have come into our life? Man, as it is already said, human being is completely inclined to play. Right? Whether run or swimming, whatsoever, or jumping, because it has become necessary for him. Earlier, he has to run to save himself from the wild animals. So he had run it. And jumping was necessary, and so he jumped. And swimming was necessary, and so he swam. He was not knowing that it was a sport one day. So we need not have to see our history. And if you see your Olympics, this Olympics have started way back in Greece. Right? Way back, BC somewhere, it has started in Greece. Stopped. Once again they started. Right? Almost every sport which is recognized by the world, it is there, competition is there. People go there and they feel it is a prestigious entry. To have an entry into the Olympic Games, it brings a great prestige to you, a place in the society. And I need not tell about your Sindhu, PV Sindhu, recently in badminton. She won the silver medal. And what kind of recognition we have given? The whole of India, not only whole of India, in the world she got the claim. And here we have appreciated, applauded, and we recognized it. Right? What money she got, that is immaterial. But what is the fame she got? Why? Olympic return. Olympic, she played silver medal. She won it. And till date, we are talking about your Usha. Right? And she is called as Kerala Express. P.T. Usha. Still date we are talking about her. Milkha Singh, there was a picture. Right? And his abilities, his agility, his running. All these things. Bhag Milkha Bhag, we have seen it. We applauded it by seeing picture. And if it is reality, how much? So these are all the things. Mane, because you are a sportsman, you will be recognized by the people. So, immemorial from Greek time, Olympics if you see. Now Asian Games, many, many things have come. So, in that, this is the reason why sports and games from times immemorial have been our best source of amusement. You see, it was amusement when I am being chased by some wild animal and I am not coming into its reach and I am keeping myself away. I am defeating it. So an amount of happiness I do have. Not necessarily I should be given a medal here, but I could escape from a very wild animal. So that is the prize given to me. And by then, I am getting a kind of happiness within, amusement within. So, amusement and entertainment. Any sporting activity involves physical exertion, any sport if you call. If I am running, these hands are moving like this, the legs are moving, and here this one, the shin, and it is ankle, and the toes, even the fingers, right? Even my backbone. These are all very alert, then only I can run. Where I am putting my step? Physically, an agility comes in my body and it becomes very strong, right? So physically, I am getting benefited. And with an individual or a team, again you see, as an individual, that is 100 meters race or 400 meters hurdle. If it is hurdle, then relay, there are four people involved. In a team, I am running hurdles and your relay race. In that, four people are involved, right? And I will have to see that my team is winning. Team spirit would come, right? If somebody makes a mistake, You can understand how much humiliation he gets. So these are all means feelings, bodily exertion, and all these things are put together in the sports. Skill with an individual or a team engaged in competition with one another for honor or sheer entertainment or both. It may be for sheer entertainment I am running, or it may be for a competition to get an honor. Maybe both, maybe single. Means when I am running, I should enjoy it. And so I say, whatever you do, you enjoy it. Even if you are reading it, try to enjoy. Then it becomes easy. When you are taking part in a running race, try to enjoy it. Then surely you are going to win it. If from the very beginning, if you have determined that I may not win, and you are sorrowful over there, sad over there, doubtful over there, then you cannot win. So enjoy it. So that enjoyment will also be there. Entertain or both. It helps us to develop physically, mentally, and socially too. So now if you see, there are physical, mental, and social. You have to take two games and you have to tell how they are beneficial for your physique. Maintenance of our physical health and maintenance of your mental health and to maintain the social status. So if you are playing some cricket, internationally famous game, right? Or you are playing snooker, a board, some balls, a frame, it is kept over there, and you have the sticks, right? And with that stick, you are shooting a ball, and that ball hits the other in a certain angle, and that ball goes to that pocket which others have not expected. That is snooker. And there you are using your mind and you are walking around the board. You are thinking, and when the ball is hit correctly and when it is pocketed, when other fellow did not expect the shot, then you will get an amount of enjoyment. And also you will have a social acclaim. You will have, yes, this person, no, he plays snooker very nice. Right? Soccer, football, volleyball. People become masters in that. People recognize him for that play. Oh, that fellow, he plays kabaddi nice, no? That fellow, yeah, he plays kabaddi, I know. Since last 10 years I know him, he is playing very well. And also in the interstate and national level play, he got the first prize there. That way talk will be there in the society. Your recognition is your game, your sport. That way socially you are gaining, mentally you are gaining, and physically you are gaining. You have to choose, discuss in small groups, and select two games that according to you develop as the best physically, mentally, and socially. You have to take two, and you have to write about that here, reasons of your choice, why. How they are important for your physical development, how those games are important for your mental development, and here socially you have developed, you got a sort of status in the society, and how you can get it. Now there are certain names here, and many games are there, all are classified under these names. There are hundreds and thousands of sports and games being played all over the world. We know very few. I say we know very few, right? However, we can play them under the following categories in order to know about them in a more convenient and systematic manner. Some of the categories are as follows. There are many categories. Each and every game fall under certain category. And there are n number, but we are discussing here about only 10 categories. Let us see. First of all, team sports. Oh, right from cricket, hockey, kabaddi. Yeah, if at all you are going on putting your doubles, mixed doubles, these are all team up games. So team sports. Athletics. Athletics, javelin throw, discus throw, hammer throw, jumping, long jump, high jump, pole vault jumping, running, bicycling. These are all athletics, right? And now comes gymnasts, gymnastics. That is going somersaults and jumping, and you are controlling your body. You are having 1, 2, 3 somersaults and you are reaching there. Within that area itself, you are stopping that one and going somersaults in the air. These are called gymnastics. Means somersault means not only like this, like this also they go, right? And rocket sports, rocket. Your what we call shuttlecock, shuttlecock badminton, and you have ball, woolen ball badminton. And I feel whether this game is there or not, if at all it is there, in Tamil Nadu it is being played. And now, slowly probably that is extinct, I feel. I have not seen so far it one, when shuttlecock has come. And shuttlecock is also racket, and your lawn tennis squashing. These are all racket played. And water sports, yachting is there, right? And wind surfing, and again sculling, and your kayaking, yachting, these are all come under your that, what is it called, water sports. Not only that, the surfing board, that is also comes under this water sports. Combat sports, that is fencing yourself, fighting with a sword, right? Having mask everywhere, you will be dueling. You will be fighting with others. That is combat. And in that again, wrestling is there. In that again, kick wrestling is there. And many boxing, kickboxing, boxing, and all these things are under weight, separate weighting. They are the weightage. We have that kind of combat sports. And again, we have target sports. Rifle, arrow, bow and arrow, right? These are all targeting. Right, and next comes your motor sports, Formula One, right, go-karting, and even your motorcycle going, what is it called as your rural sports they go, right? These are all comes under motor sports. And equestrian is horse riding, right? That horse riding, you have to see how he gallops. It is not simply racing. Maybe he would be having jumping over the hurdles. That is equestrian with the horse. Now, adventure. Adventure, you are trekking. Right? And you are adventure, even you are swimming. What? A canal. Means in the ocean. Not the swimming, all these things. You are swimming across the ocean, right? Canals, Panama Canal, between two countries that you are crossing. Indian Channel, you are crossing. These are all comes under your adventure, fun and indigenous sports. Lastly, we have fun and indigenous sports. Indigenous, Coco, Kabaddi, and even many other sports are there, right? There are played locally. That way the sports can be bifurcated into many classes. And now under this, working in small groups of 4 or 5, we have again, there are many sports here. Paragliding, there will be a glider, right? That we will be tying to our stomach and shoulders, everything, and we run and we leave the mountain, the edge of the mountain, and we go into the air. And then we are steering it. Slowly we are gliding, and we are coming to this spot again. For how long can you be in the air with that glider? It matters. Winning point. And go-karting. A small motor like vehicles, and that you are going down, right? And hurdles, there will be obstacles, and over that you are jumping. And next, pommel horse, that is also again horse, and with that horse we are playing many tricks. We are playing on the, right, sitting on the horse back, and when the horse is running with a great speed, even then we are pointing at something and we are lifting something. These are all pommel horse. Basketball, I need not to tell you what it is, because every person knows it, what is a basketball. And windsurfing, there is a yacht, a very small yacht, and there will be what we call as a sails for it, and those sails I can turn to my ease, right? I am having feet on that one and hands on this day, we are steering, and according to the air I am going, right? Speedily I am moving. That is called windsurfing. Formula One, the car race, we have seen many times. Judo, combating, right? And sculling. Sculling, again, a very narrow boat. This is being done in Kerala. Very narrow, lengthy boat will be there. And there will be people sitting with two oars. And they will be driving it, or what we can say, going inside that, paddling it in such a manner. It is just like a race. That's called sculling. And now fencing, as I told you, fencing, the fighting with the sword. And then comes your kayaking. Kayaking, it is a round shaped basket like thing, and it is covered with a plastic a sheet underneath. When it is put in the water, it won't drown, right? In that you have to sail, and with one oar you have to direct it, and you have to come out of that. Many dangers will be there in between. Water, many times it will be turning. Even then, along with that water, you have to come out. That is called kayaking. And now, pole vaulting. Pole vaulting means about 10 meters you go up and leave the pole with which you have carried to that level. And you have to leave this pole this side, and you have to jump that side. So now, kayaking, pole vaulting, we have seen dressage. On the horse, he sits on the saddle. And he does like this. Means that is an indication for the horse to move, what you know, in a very stylish manner the horse moves. You have to, we cannot describe it, but simply we have to see how he does it. And then suddenly he increases speed and jumps. Jumps over a castle like thing. Jumps over the hurdles, are there, over that also it will be jumping. And he makes it. And before that, he will be just, very slowly. And also the hoofs, tuck, that way making them, as if it is dancing. That is also a kind of a sport, right? Dressage. And after dressages, squash. I already told you, there will be two people having rackets, and they will be smashing a ball towards the wall. Squash. And next, kickboxing. In combat category, kickboxing is also a kind of a sport. And I need not tell you about your Koko, Kung Fu, right? Malkamb. Malkamb, mainly we can see in Karnataka and Maharashtra. That is a pole-like thing will be there. And he will be, barehandedly, he will be climbing it. And he will be making all gymnastics over that. That is Malkamb. That is Indian gymnastics, we can say. And now, snowboarding. Snow on that, the surfboarding, just like that was snowboarding, will also be there. And golf. Golf is a play, very rich play, and also we can say very majestic play, we can say it. And we will come to know in this next passage, we'll be coming to know what is that golf. And now, decathlon. Decathlon, it is a sport in which this participant has to cover 10 events. Running, cycling, swimming, these are the things we know. Maybe fast walking, or creeping under certain things, climbing under the rope walls, right? And from there jumping again, long jumping. These are all 10 events you will be covering within a given time or within a very short period he has to cover that. That is called decathlon. About 10 events he has to cover. Cricket, I need not tell you, you know it pretty well. Soccer, that is football. And again, snooker. Snooker, I told you, the board and six pockets on it, balls on it, frame, and with sticks they play, right? That is snooker. And again, kabaddi. Here, kabaddi is our Indian play. I need not say much about your coco and kabaddi because it is there in our state even here. And now, after having known the n number of sports and this classification, we have a sport here. I can say we have to take it sportively here because most of us we write, but we don't bother for a certain things, right? If that certain things we don't bother, we are the losers. What is that one? Suppose you are running, suppose you are driving a car or you are riding a bicycle. You need not to see all these things surroundings. You are to, right? And how you are just going like that, where you have to stop and how to stop again. Slow cycling, that is an art again. And how to pedal it, how to move forward, how to where to stop, and all these things you have to know it, you have to have it. In the same manner, in writing also, you should have some restrictions while you are writing. If you put them, you can read well. If you read well, you can understand well. Those are called as your punctuation marks. Where to stop, where to start. Stop and start, if you do not know, then you cannot be a winner in the game, right? Where to raise your speed means where to raise your voice. That is also the words will tell you, and there you have to use your punctuation marks. For this punctuation, what is necessary? To be able to read in a good manner and understand it, it is a must. And the other external things how you can put is the capital letter. When a sentence gets started, the first word, the first letter is a capital when sentence we are starting. And for a paragraph, as per your British mode, British method, you have to leave 5 spaces and you have to start the sentence. Then you will know this is a paragraph. In American method, align it to the left. That you should know. First of all, the first letter or the first word of the line sentence, it should be capital letter. And next, when the sentence gets ended, you have to put full stop if it is a statement. And if it is a question, you have to put a question mark. If it is exclamatory, you have to put the mark of exclamatory. Suppose you are uttering some interjections. Oh, right? Thank you. Oh God. These are all your what we call interjections. After that, you have to put mark of exclamation, right? And in certain times, you have to stop. In certain areas, you have to omit one letter. In certain areas, you have to omit one word. Then what you have to provide over there, how we should understand a letter is omitted. Apostrophe, comma you have to use. And you are writing within the paragraph, a certain part is a spoken one. How do you know it is spoken one? You have to keep inverted commas there, right? If you keep all these things, for the reader it becomes easier to read, for the person one who is hearing, it becomes easier to understand. Now, there is a paragraph here. Let us see what are the punctuation marks we can give. Capital letter I said in the beginning of the sentence, first word, first letter. Then capital letters are to be used with all the proper nouns. proper noun, wherever it comes, we have to use the capital letter. And third, when we are abbreviating a very lengthy one, whenever we are abbreviating a very lengthy expression, there the all the letters which represent that, those should be capital letters. Headmaster, you are abbreviating it, HM, H should be capital, M should be capital. Prime Minister, P should be capital, M should be capital. And all the degrees, BA, MA, MBBS, LLM, BEd, these are all abbreviated for a lengthy thing and lengthy title, lengthy qualification, and those are to be put in capital letters, and that is in letters, English alphabet, and that should be, alphabet should be capital letters. These are all there, we have to very meticulously follow this, then your writing should be very nice. People can understand what you are writing. Immaterial whether your handwriting is bad or worse whatsoever. If you are maintaining this, automatically your handwriting becomes nice. So here is a paragraph. A new age cycle, rickshaw. A new age, that A should be capital letter. Because it is starting, sentence is being started. And if it is in between, A need not have to be a capital letter. Wherever you are writing I for yourself, I, pronoun I, that should be a capital letter, not small. I have seen many of the students, they write small I. No, you are not at all a small fellow. You are a very big fellow. That way you have to give respect to yourself. And so capital I should be there. Capital I for all the I's. Right? And now, a new age cycle rickshaw. Cycle rickshaw is a common noun, so we need not have to put C capital and R rickshaw capital, we need not have to put. Even if you put, there is no harm because we are talking about it. And now, that is light on the both the pockets and the calf muscle. Calf muscle is this. When a rickshaw puller is pedaling it, that doesn't take much weight because it is a cycle rickshaw. And there is a pulling rickshaw. Men used to pull that. Right? If the load is there and if it, a man has to pull, now you can understand how much weight we are having on our this calf muscle. And now rickshaw means we have to pedal it and it will be moving. There are three wheels. And controlled by a free wheel and a crank, right? And you are putting less effort and you are getting more work done. Means we can say it is a lever in the name of the physics. So cycle rickshaw, it is lighter to your pocket, because if you hire an auto, he will be charging much, and a rickshaw fellow, and because he has to put his own energy into it, so he may be charging less, and so less weight on the pocket also, it is said. On both pocket and the calf muscles of rickshaw pullers, mobile games designed to battle life-threatening diseases like HIV, AIDS, and TB, and a low-cost computer that enables visually challenged students to read the textbooks. These are all new inventions. See, he talked about these many. And until end, there are three things he had put. So whenever you are completing about that item, you have to break it with a comma. So here, rickshaw pullers, after that, there is a breakage, and new item started, mobile. So there, we have to have a comma. Mobile games designed to battle life-threatening diseases like HIV, it is a abbreviated one, and so H capital, I capital, V capital, and again AIDS, AIDS, all four capital letters, and TB, so T capital and B capital, and a low, here end is there, So before any conjunction, no comma. Earlier, if at all you are having three strings, we have to use three commas for all the three to separate, and after and there is no comma before the and and after and. And a low cost computer that enables visually challenged students to read the textbooks. These are all new inventions. There you have to full stop, because the whole paragraph is one sentence and you are stopping at each and every interval, putting a comma. After putting a comma, you have to have a little bit gap between this string of words and this string of words. You have to keep a comma and a space, one letter space. Nobody is bothering nowadays where it starts and where it stops. We don't know. That way they are writing the paragraphs. And now lastly, these are all new inventions. There we have to put a full stop. The sentence come to a stop there. Remaining all we are putting commas. HIV, AIDS and TB we are putting capital letters, because these are the abbreviated ones for the diseases. So that way we have successfully completed the first sentence punctuation. Now these are, again T, these, we are starting a new paragraph and a new word and a new letter T. The T should be capital letter. These are not innovations designed by Fong Suk, Wang Duk, Rancho Das. You see, you are very familiar with this name, right? Who is he? Our Amir Khan in Three Idiots, right? And it is a name, and so we have to put Fong Suk, P, with the P is a capital. Wang Duk, W, capital. Rancho Das, R, capital. And you can put Das as a small letter, because it is the whole name complete. And in certain names, this is Das is a surname. When it is divided into two parts, the other D with Das, that should be capital. Here it is not necessary, because Rancho Das is one name. And Shyamala Das, Rancho Das, Shyamala Das. Yes, again here capital. Of Chachad is a place, and so C should be capital. Chachad. Of three idiots, all titles. You see here title, D, T capital, world, W capital. Of not necessary, because it is the preposition there. And here sports, S capital. That way in a title, if you are writing, all the words should be with the capital, excepting conjunction and prepositions. These we need not have to put in capital letters, but remaining all we have to put capital letters, because you are to do some exercise, you have to give titles. And the title is designed like this, right? With capitals. Please remember that. So here, Three Idiots is the title of a picture, and so I should be capital. And now, fame, much before Amir Khan, A-A-M-I-R. First A is capital, because it is a name. Khan, it is a surname, and so K is capital. Khan's Rancho, he is called as Rancho, right? And so that is a pet name. Even then, it is a proper noun, and so we have to put it a capital, Rancho. Made innovation a household word, these simple but powerful ideas were being quietly conceptualized and put to practice by enterprising Indians. I capital, it has been given, you see, Indians, because a class of people are called like that. So it is India, and Indian should be capital. In various concerns, of the country. We can see many innovations. You can see that is a what is that one called, a knife. It has to be sharpened, right? Earlier people used to carry a machine which is being plied with a rope, right? Then it is going round and round and round, and that the knives are, your scissors are getting sharpened. Now he goes on a bicycle, and the bicycle, if it is pedaled on the stand, right, that wheel is going round, and he is pedaling and he is putting that, means the workload is getting lower, lighter and easier. That is the main idea about innovation, innovative ideas, right? We have seen many innovative ideas which are being invented by our, or discovered, we can say, of our Rancho Das, that is Chachad. We have seen in the picture, three idiots, right? So that is the paragraph, that is how we have to do the punctuation marks. Now we see the story of Ashok Kumar. I already told you, he was a boy, right? And he goes to Delhi, leaving his house in Bihar. What for? In search of a livelihood. A boy. Because poverty is that. Poverty is such that he cannot have anything at his hometown. So better leave it and go somewhere and earn. And now he joins in a club as a boy. Means boys are required to carry the sticks are there, no? Clubs they are called. Those clubs are to be carried, and different clubs they use at different angles they use it. And there is a cart like thing, a very long one, and in that all the clubs will be kept, and that trolley like thing you have to push it and take it, because it is a rich people's game. Rich people cannot carry all these things. Only one club they will be having in hand, and they walk in a style, and they again they hit it, and the ball goes, and again they go walk. And the boys, they carrying this trolley, push trolley thing with the clubs, they also accompany them. In that capacity he joined there, right? And also you can see the tennis courts will be there, courts. In that one, boys will be there picking up the balls and giving it to the players, right? And maintaining the net, maintaining that, what we call the court, right? All these things are giving towels, are giving water to the players when they are in practice. These are all the boys, they do it. Because they are boys, they can be engaged at a cheaper rate, the people can keep it. And moreover, the adults, if they are adults, when you are becoming an adult, you are becoming a bit lazy, careless also. But if they are boys, they feel enthusiast. Means, I am carrying this, I am doing a great job. That kind of feeling would be there with them. Though it is a livelihood, they have a feeling, right? And a cap will be given. Donning that cap, having this push trolley, they feel as if they are doing a great job. So that way he joined over there. And how he got the interest in playing golf, right? How he mastered it, what help he got from the society, and now in which position he is, right? That is what we are going to learn here in this lesson. Means social benefit by sports. This is what we call as a rags to riches story. Rags, hardly the shirt covers my back, remaining all torn or something, buttons are not there, hardly, that is called a rag. To, from that position to riches, very rich he has become. How he could able to go like that? In many fields, this kind of people are there, many fields, in even business. So-called business people, now what you call they were not having even a pie to suffice the hunger of their children. They had come crossing the border from Pakistan to here when our India got bifurcated, separated. India, Hindustan, and Pakistan. People have come and now settled here, and they used to do small errands. How they have grown, we do not know, but in a span of 70 years, they have earned millions. Most of the businessmen are like that only. I need not take names. So here, that is called rags to riches. So the passage goes like this. Ashok Kumar, you can see a comma has been put over there. Why? Ashok Kumar, one of the country's leading golfer, there it is a comma, because we are talking something about the Ashok Kumar, right? So a comma has been put. Leading golfer who rose from the ranks of a caddy, remembers his very humble beginnings very distinctly. The reason I am here in this swanky restaurant of the Oberoi, sipping coffee with you, is because of golf. It has brought me name, fame and money and all that I could possibly ask for in life. Without golf, I am a zero, said the 27-year-old golfer with rare candor in a chat with Kalyan Ashok, a sports journalist working with Sports Star, one of India's leading sports weeklies. Now, where is the comma used? Just see to it. Wherever something extra is talked about the person who has been introduced earlier in the sentence, immediately after that comma is there, description is there. See here, Kalyan Ashok, comma is there. And who is he? A sports journalist working with Sports Star. What is Sports Star? A comma, one of India's leading sports weeklies. That is where we have to use comma. And next, India's number 3 golfer may not exactly be rolling in luxury at the moment, but he definitely leads a comfortable life, a far cry from the days when he used to sleep in a stable. How his life has started. Earlier he was sleeping in a stable. India's number 3 golfer may not exactly be rolling in luxury at the moment, but he definitely leads a comfortable life, a far cry from the days when he used to sleep in a stable. Stable where we leave the horses. We keep the horses over there. There he used to sleep. Why? When he had come all the way from Bihar to this place, he was appointed there to look after the horses. It's destiny that brought me to this stage in life, and I can't say that I deserve it, but it's God's gift to me through golf, said Ashok, not the one to forget his past. Ashok Kumar keeps reminding himself how he came up in life. So that is very essential thing. However great you may become tomorrow, but today, the past today, you should not forget. It may be very sweet tomorrow, but the bitterness which you have come across today, this day, you should not forget. So that is the great quality of this Ashok Kumar. He never forgets his past. Simply he says, it is destiny. It has to be done, and so it has been done. Right? Jo jo hone ka tha, wo ho gaya mere saath. Isliye main is jagah pe hoon. That way, he says, he doesn't speak a single word with pride, no proud at all. So, his story is stranger than fiction. If at all you see his story, you may feel it is a fiction, but it is stranger than a fiction. Ashok was born into a poor family in Bihar that struggled to make both ends meet. Means, second time the dinner, if it is there or not, he doesn't know. And if he eats this chapati now, can there be a second chapati served? He doesn't know. Those were the days for him in Bihar. Means utter starvation. He has four brothers and two sisters. In 1988, his parents sent him away with his elder brother to Delhi. Elder brother, he is working in Delhi somewhere. And you see, you are not having enough food here. At least you go with your brother, you can do something, you can earn and you can send something here, or you can eat properly there. That way the parents are just compromising with their poverty. Sending the children, go. Because here you are starving. Better if you go over there, we don't know at least whether you are starving or eating well. At least we will be thinking that you are eating well. Go. Compromisation. So he had come out of that. He has come from that kind of a family in Bihar. And he worked as an errand boy at the Jaipur Polo Club. Polo, you see, it is a game. Sitting on the horsebacks, they will be playing polo with clubs. They will be driving ball into the goal. And it is a game for the rich people and also a livelihood for the poor people. So, I used to work in the day assisting my brother and sleep in the stable at night. In the morning I used to assist my brother and in the night I used to sleep in the stable. The club also had the Air Force golf course and I wandered. Wandered to go about. Wandered onto it one day and watched the players and caddies. I thought of becoming a caddy, but I was too young then. I did not get the job, but the club hired me a few years later. Recalls Ashok. It was then that he took to golf. He took to golf means took interest in that game golf. He started practicing in the club when no one was around. However, he was caught playing one day and was suspended from his job, as caddies were not allowed to practice golf. Now you see, luck, and again, immediately after that, bad luck. Bad luck is due to what? Because of interest. His interest to learn golf. And now, it is restricted for the caddies. Caddy means, I already told you, a boy who carries all the clubs and all the essentials for the player. They have to go meters together, yards together, right? They will be going on, hitting the ball until it goes into that pocket, they will be walking. And when they walk, their clubs and every essential things, the boys have to carry. And they are paid for that. But whenever there is nobody around, all the errands he has completed, he has taken care of the lawn and the grass and everything, he has taken care. But there is time still. What is to be done? He too started playing. And which is, according to rules, he should not play golf there. And someday he was caught. He was suspended from the job. Now again he comes to the square one. To come to square one means wherever he started, then again there comes. Means he was a poor boy and penniless to eat. There again he comes and stands in that position. I was back to square one. Then I went away to help a lorry owner. What is to be done? I am to earn. I cannot stick here. I was back to square one. Then I went away to help a lorry owner. Means, he is not the lorry helper or lorry cleaner. not driver even, he used to help him doing some small, small jobs. Who was transporting sand? He was having lorries, but he used to transport sand. I remember the days when I had to pay 5 rupees to hire a blanket during winter and sleep in Connaught Place, Ashok said wistfully. Wistfully, playfully. Means it was a time how I spent that, and that covering myself, I should not feel ashamed for that, because those were the days I learned something. Used to pay 5 rupees as a rent to hire a blanket to sleep in the Connaught Place. You see to it. Means he is not afford even to buy a blanket. He remembered that. Wistfully he remembered that. Right? 6 months later, when things cooled down, he moved back to the Air Force Golf Course and became a caddy to Amit Luthra, who was India's top golfer and an Asian Games gold medalist. Luthra Saab spoke to the club authorities and got me in, Ashok said with gratitude writ large on his face. Writ large on his face. Gratitude means all over my face, it appears that I am very grateful to that man. Very thankful to that man. Why? Again, I was called and I was helped by Luthra Saab, that I am again kept back into the club. Means earlier with this lorry owner, I was not having any kind of hopes to come into this position in the life. Now here, two things we have to see here. 6 months later, when things cooled down, he moved back to the Air Force Golf Course and became a caddy to Amit Luthra. To Amit Luthra, after that we have who was India's top golfer. Let us see, if at all we eliminate these two words, who was, what remains, or the meaning is getting changed. Let us see to it. Now I read it without using those words. So, and became a caddy to Amit Luthra, India's top golfer. Who was India's top golfer? And I eliminate who was here, right? And even then the same meaning stands. What I mean to say here is who, which, that, what, these can be very comfortably can be eliminated, can be omitted without getting the meaning changed. So, India's top golfer and an Asian Games gold medalist, Luthra Saab spoke to the club authorities and got me in, Ashok said with gratitude writ large on his face. Now, Ashok learned a lot from Luthra one, and one day he challenged his mentor to play off. What occurred to him, he doesn't know. He learned many skills in that. Right? What we can say is very traits in playing golf. He learned it. And one day he said, because you see, childish, no? Childish mentality. And he challenged, Luthra Saab, one day I will beat you in golf. Simply he said that. And now you can see what he says here. I don't know what got into my head. What entered into my head, I do not know. Right? And I told him that I will beat him. To which Luthra said that if I did, that he would waive a month's caddy fee. Okay. If at all you are winning over me, one time, 1 month, the caddy fee you need not to pay. Why? The caddy is also allowed to play there after him and for a moderate fees. So that you need not to pay. We played on the road, but I lost. Ashok smiled, but I lost. He smiled. Means you can understand. Means this Luthra Saab was just thought, I am losing the game. What is this? And at that moment, Ashok willfully did some mistake and he made Luthrasap gain it. Why? Win it. Why? That is what he doesn't want to. And so he smiled here and said that I lost my game with Luthrasap. But what happened? Luthra, however, was very impressed with the young man's talent and got him enrolled at the Delhi Golf Club, which allowed caddies to play. Seizing this opportunity with both hands, Ashok went on to improve his game by leaps and bounds, and in 1995, DGC, you see abbreviated here, all capitals, D, Delhi Golf Club, DGC, selected him to play in the All India Junior Tournament in Calcutta. So, this play, the challenge which he put for Luthrasap, that was the turning point. And losing the game also a turning point. And so he smiled here. Right? He would have won it. But Luthrasap's ego might have been hampered if at all he won. And so knowingly he lost it. And that made Luthra to look into his career in a, what we can say, in a fatherly love. And he tamed him. Come on, come on. And what he did? He enrolled him in the DGC. He took this opportunity with both the hands, means he embraced it. He took it. Come on. I didn't know where Calcutta was. I was sent to Calcutta to play the juniors, All India Juniors Tournament. I am at Delhi and originally from Bihar. People in Bihar, they used to say, let us go to Calcutta, but I don't know where it is. And now I'll have to go there. I was thinking Calcutta is out of my country somewhere. I don't know. Why? This is my area. Only this. So, how he traveled. I did not know where Calcutta was. I thought it was outside the country. I traveled in an unreserved compartment, spending most of the time sitting in the bathroom or just outside, as there was no place elsewhere. So now you can understand how many people daily commuting, traveling, just in the unreserved compartments, sitting wherever there is a place where I can keep my one of the buttocks comfortably. There are people, and if you go to the northern side states, you can see the people traveling on the top of the buses and on the top of the railway compartments, means daring for the electrical, high tension electrical wires also, they travel like that. So it is one of the cases where our Ashok Kumar traveled to Calcutta. Earlier to traveling, he was not knowing, he was not having any idea as to where Calcutta is. He was thinking it is outside the country. Right? So, in Calcutta, he finished third, and in the next 2 years, he became the junior champion of the country. In 2000, he moved to the amateur ranks, and 2 years later, he became a pro, finishing his first session as India's number 5 golf player. Riding a wave of success, Ashok held the number 1 spot in 2006 and 2008, and currently 2010, he is ranked number 3. So now you can just imagine what was he and what is he now. India's golf number 1, it is not a small achievement. It is really a lifetime achievement. He could do it within a very short span. In 2000, he was sent to Calcutta to play as a, what is it called, national junior golf. He was to play. There he proved himself. and then there is no looking back. Continuously, he was counted as 5, 3 and 1, and now he is 2010, he ranked 3. So, the moment he cherishes the most as a player is not the time when he won his first major title, but when he finished 18th in the Hero Honda DLF tournament in 2002, it fetched him a check of rupees 1 lakh. I never looked back after that, Ashok remarked. 2000, he won Calcutta. But his most good achievements, what he called, he cherished still, he remembers. What is it? 2002, he played Hero Honda Champion Golf Tournament. And in that, though he scored 18, he was, is it 18th? He was presented with a check of one lakh. Then economically, he became very sound. And there was no looking back for practicing the golf. So, in the early part of 2010, Ashok's golfing career got a boost when the Bangalore-based business and software company Kesaya India, run by golf enthusiast Mr. Girish Krishnamurthy, decided to sponsor him. I am a single guy and with Kesaya around to take care of other things, I can concentrate better on my game. On my game now, Ashok says, with determination as well as gratitude, it is his ardent wish that all golf links in the country should support caddies, as he feels that many of them have a lot of inherent talent simply waiting to be tapped. You see, who can play the best is the man, one who is associated with the game or the sport 24 hours and 7 weeks. Who are they? Hardly the people, one who deal with the field, deal with the balls, deal with the clubs. Those are caddies in the case of golf. If it is football, and if it is cricket, and if it is tennis, you can understand. There are many people who knows ins and outs. And though he did not come into the field, he knew pretty well how to play it. And so here, he not only recommended caddies to be taken attention, all the people who are in the field of that, helping the players to play, they should also be given a chance. That was his keen interest. Ashok has modeled his game on his golfing idol, Tiger Woods. Incidentally, he had met Tiger when he was a caddy to Arjun Atwal in Bangkok a decade ago. He hugged me when he was introduced by Atwal as a top amateur from India. I asked him for his advice, to which the legendary golfer simply said, "Don't think of beating others. They should think of beating you." Now, you see, every player, when he was about to play, what he or she has in mind, if you question, he will say, "I will win the gold medal. That is what I want to beat this, that, and I want to reach over there." Don't think like that. Be a normal player. Simply, you should have your ambition that I will play well. I will play well, that's all. Then that thing itself, that thought itself will take you to the success. That is what your Tiger Woods, the, what we can say, idol of our Ashok Kumar, he advised. Don't try to beat others. Why? They may also think to beat you. So you play your game. don't try to beat, then what happens? You surpass all the hurdles and you can play well. Ashok's eyes sparkled when he recalled his meeting with Tiger. When I mentioned who is your idol, did you meet him? And when he said this account, his eyes sparkled. He faithfully follows the advice from the maestro. Maestro means master in that art. Maestro. Hopes to play with him one day. For the moment, I eat, drink, and sleep golf. For the moment, I eat, drink, and sleep golf. I think this dialogue of our Ashok Kumar must have just took you back somewhere where Amitabh Bachchan says, I eat cricket, drink cricket, and sleep cricket in that. Right? There is no discretion in my life, distraction in my life. I relax with some music and watch series of Tiger Woods. Simply I watch him how he plays. Then remaining time I practice it. There is no distraction. There is no question of disturbance at all. I cannot distract myself from golf. This is what Ashok Kumar put as his experience in the game. What we learned is, through a sport a man can reach from rags to the riches. Sports is one of the means to take you within no time. That is what we are learning here. Under D5, what we have just seen. Given below are some qualities that a human being may possess. On the basis of your reading of the passage, pick three qualities that you think the ace Indian golfer Ashok Kumar possesses, and using incidents or statements to justify your choice in a short paragraph around 100 to 150 words. Means we have to write something about Ashok Kumar and his character. Here are many clues have been given to you. Clues, something you can take in for Ashok, some you can discard. No, this quality is not there in Ashok Kumar. So now, pride. Is he proud? No. Why? How can I say it? If at all he is proud, he would not have told about his sleeping in the stable. He did not say. And again, when he was practicing, somebody sees and he was suspended. Because a proud man doesn't speak about his failures. But Ashok Kumar had spoken about his failure. Not only that, he traveled to Calcutta sitting where? You can imagine, if a proud man is there, he would not have spoken that. These you can tell as examples for that. 150 words you can write. Right? Not only on one, we have to take three. And one, this one. Second, frankness. Yeah, he is very frank. He put all the details. All the details means how he was at Bihar. Right? How many brothers and how many sisters? Why he had to go to Delhi with his elder brother? And what happened after reaching over there? How he has been suspended from that golf club? Right? How he traveled from here to Calcutta? And his ignorance also he submitted. I do not know where Calcutta is. I think it is there somewhere out of the country. Very frankly he said. His ignorance he put it. And all his hardships he put it. So we can say he is a very frank. He has frankness as the quality. Jealousy, no. Not at all. Right? And next, humility. Okay? And perseverance. Yes, he has that. Under many difficult circumstances even, he took them very sportively. But one goal, that is to play golf, he could able to achieve it. That is called perseverance. That is to have that kind of zeal with him to live with, to achieve that. Means no matter what may occur, he did not, his heart did not go down, never. He was always cheerful, always optimistic, right? That is what perseverance. Now, compassion. If he does not have that compassion, he would not have come to Delhi, because he cared for his family. Compassion is nothing but care, right? And he cared everybody. You can see all along he cared. Cared for his service, cared for the so-and-so, his mentor. Everything we can see here. So, and goal orientation, third one. You should have a goal in your life. At any stage you can make out. Then when you make your goal fixed, you have to look at that only. Just like Arjuna, when Dronacharya asked all the prince over there, what do you look? Can you see that on the tree there is a bird? Can you see? People said many things. We have seen the leaves, we have seen the branch, we have seen the green bird. All these things, many things have been told. But when it comes to the Arjuna's time, he said, I can see the eye. The sparkle in the eye, I can see. Eye is nothing but the target. So, that should be your mentality. You can see here, Ashok Kumar, till he came to Delhi, he was not having any goal in his life. Only goal is to earn and fill his stomach, sleep somewhere. But when he has gone into the golf field, he took some interest on that. He became enthusiastic. Then he was knowing that he may be suspended, but took the risk. Thereafter, because of that itself, he was once again reinstated by the golfer, ace golfer of India. Right? And now, as only a helping hand in the club, he could able to achieve, first of all, the juniors, and then amateurs, then the masters. And his aim is, lastly, what he said, he wants to play at least with the Tiger Wood, the golf he wanted to play with him, at least once. That is called goal, and he is called as a goal orientation man. So now, first one is frankness he has. Second, perseverance. Third, goal orientation. On these three, on each and every quality, you have to write 50 words. Picking up the sentences over there, giving as an example, I told all these things to you. So now, in D6 we have A column and B column. Under A we can see words or phrases. Under B we can see the meanings of that. How best we can match these two, that we have to see. So the journalist has used some lovely words and expressions in the above story. Match the words and groups of words with the meanings given here in the B column. Now swanky, S-W-A-N-K-Y, swanky. And what is the meaning of that is fashionable and expensive. At F the meaning is there. And candor, two. The candor, the meaning here we have frankness. Now third, a far cry from, third. And this third is very different. Far cry means a very different one. Stranger than fiction is four. Highly unbelievable. When we say stranger than fiction, it is highly unbelievable, though it is believable. Then back to square one means what? Jaise the, jahan se shuru hai wahi jana. Back to square one. So that is, you can see here, in a return to the original situation from where one started. Jahan se nikle wahi aa jana. That is called back to square one. By leaps and bounds, in a very good progressing, that is called leaps and bounds, we say. That is at six, And here we have the meaning very quickly or in large amounts. At C we have the meaning. And now 7, inherent, which is there inside. Inherent means packed with, inclusive all. So inherent 7, we have the meaning here at H, pertaining to a natural quality that can't be removed, which is there inside originally. Now maestro, when this word has come, I told you the meaning. Maestro means a master in one art. So let us see where this exists. It is a great performer. That way we have matched this. Then D, 6 is completed, D7. Use the above words in expressions in meaningful sentences. You are right, meaningful sentences. You can use the example where the journalist has used this word. What can be the meaning of the sentence? Why can't I restructure the sentence in my own words? That way you have to copy, but not completely copy. You can simply, what we can say is, follow it, how it has been written. And next, D8, you must be fond of sports or any hobby like painting or dancing or singing. Imagine that you have become a star in your field of interest. One day, you meet a poor boy with a lot of talent, but no resources to get himself the facilities to nurture his talent. As a successful person who is very interested in about doing it, write a diary entry on any given data 10 years after from now about the feelings that the young but poor talented person evoked in you and the plans you thought of to develop his potential. You see the situation. You are very talented in one art. You are a master in one art. And when you have achieved your success, accidentally you met a boy of having interest in your art. Now you have to go home and you have to write a diary entry. How you met him, what talent he is, what are your feeling for him and his talents. Right? How your talent has been could be patronized by somebody, and how you feel about that boy. Do you want to patronize him? That way you have to write your diary entry. It should be as if you are speaking to yourself. Diary entry should be always as if you are speaking to yourself, you have to write it. And because the diary, it has the date, etc., you have to put only the time when you are writing it. A book is there, a diary, right? In that page, you have the date. And so you have to put the date and time here, and the day also you can write. So suppose it is today. What is the date today? Date is 27th. And what is the day? Saturday. 27th August, 16th, Saturday. And this afternoon, it is a bit sultry. I tried to sleep, but could not. Had a thought. Why I should not consult my diary. And so I am here with my pen ready. Just when I was about to write, I remember the person, the boy, the young boy, hardly 12 years. That short, abrupt and meaningful words and sentences you have to write. Not that something you are writing, no. Don't bother for the grammar. It should give a meaning and it should give an emotion when you are writing diary. Please remember that. Diary writing is separate than essay writing. Essay writing, you are going on describing things in your skills. And while you are making the entry in the diary, it should rouse the emotion when it is read. Right? And now we have E. Under E, we have nature's medicine.